Hi everyone, welcome to the Fantasy Football Update. I'm Lauren Shahadi alongside Jamie Eisenberg and Jimmy. I want to talk to you, first start out talking to you about Detroit, Cincinnati. Detroit, of course, got the win 27-10. What about Cincinnati offense? Chad Johnson, Rudy Johnson, TJ Husmanzada out. Where does Carson Palmer turn to?
Well, you know, Lauren, it's like if you're doing updates with Eric Mack as opposed to doing it with Dave and I because you're playing with second-tier talent.
Okay.
The Bengals, you know, when Carson Palmer doesn't have his top-tier guys there, when you're talking about Chad Johnson and TJ Husmanzada, he's not going to be as good, although Ben Utecht could be a very nice sleeper tight end. I think you'll see TJ Husmanzada eventually get on the field. I spoke to him recently a couple weeks ago. He's fine. He's ready to go. Just a little bit banged up with his hamstring injury. No need to worry about him. He's still worth drafting as a number one fantasy option. When you look at Chad Johnson, first we had the holdout, then he came to camp, then he had the ankle injury. Now he's got the shoulder situation. He's expected to be fine by the start of the season. You could continue to draft him as a top-end number one, a low-end number one, excuse me, high-end number two fantasy wide receiver. Lower your expectations a little bit. Jerry Rice this offseason told me he's going to be a little bit of a bust this year. I tend to agree just because all the situation involving Johnson, not necessarily a good thing. Rudy Johnson, though, Lauren, when you talk about a running back of his caliber, a guy who comes off a hamstring injury last year, dealing with a hamstring injury again, not the greatest thing, but he's still a good number two fantasy running back, a guy you could take end of the third, beginning of the fourth round, and give you some quality production.
All right, I hope Emacs not watching this. I think he's already turned it off if he was. All right, I want to talk to you more about other injuries. Mark Bulger, Tavares Jackson, what do we do with those guys?
Well, you know, when you look at those two quarterbacks, Mark Bulger obviously is the fantasy option that people are going to be concerned about because he is coming off a disappointing season, only played in five games in 2007. A lot of concerns based on what's going on around him. The offensive line banged up. No Steven Jackson as of now because of the holdout. But I think Bulger's going to be fine. You know, you talk about he still has a stud receiver in Torrey Holt, some developing talent with guys like Donnie Avery, and then a veteran guy trying to come back, you know, to prove that he's still a good player in Drew Bennett and also a tight end in Randy McMichael. I think Bulger is in that group of guys like Brett Favre, Matt Hasselbeck, Donovan McNabb, quarterbacks trying to prove that they can get back to the level of where they were in previous years. Bulger's at that level. When you look at Jackson, though, you know, a guy that doesn't necessarily have big fantasy appeal, but that team needs its quarterback to be productive because that running game is what predicates how that team is going to do. And if they don't have any passing game to stretch the field, it's going to be a little bit of a disappointment for Peterson and Taylor. So hopefully Jackson gets back out there because we don't necessarily trust Gus Frat. Also keep in mind, Ronnie Brown dealing with a thumb injury, he should be fine. And then James Hardy, rookie wide receiver, dealing with a hamstring injury. As we know, hamstring is not the best thing to talk about when you look at guys like Johnson, TJ Husmanzada, but Hardy should be okay.
That's right. All eyes are on Adrian Peterson there. All right. Well, we're going to head out to the Ray J. You just got back. We're glad you're even with us because you just got back.
Like
the Ray J, you like that? Bucks, Pats. The common thread was no offense, you know.
No.
Tom Brady on the sidelines made way for Lawrence Maroney in the run game.
Yeah, you know, it was really interesting to see Maroney, you know, get on the field finally for the first time this preseason, and he looked okay. Not the greatest stats, but the fact that they're giving him carries, you know, he's going to be sort of in that group of guys you're not sure of, or can he be great for fantasy owners, had a tremendous postseason run. I think Maroney's going to be a fantastic running back this year. A guy you can target at the end of the second round, beginning of the third round, a low-end number two fantasy option for you, but he's going to produce like a solid number two fantasy running back. So that's great news. I also talked to two former Gators. I know you're fond of that.
I know you are too.
Chad Jackson and Jabbar Gaffney. Those guys are battling for the third spot. We'll have more on that on CBSSports.com. When you look at the Bucks, no Jeff Garcia, so we're a little concerned about how the Bucks offense is going to look, but so far, so good. You know, Antonio Bryant's getting involved in the passing game, no Joey Galloway, so Bryant's stepping up there. And the running game is sort of interesting right now because Ernest Graham got on the field, another Gator, scored a touchdown. He's going to be a very good producer of getting the end zone. But Michael Bennett has really emerged now as the number two running back for the Bucks. He's really stepped up ahead of work done, no Cadillac Williams. So Bennett's a guy you can handcuff with Graham and target with a late-round pick.
And Antonio Bryant trying to revive his career kind of in Tampa Bay, doing a very good job.
That's
well,
right.
You did a great job.
Thank you
so much. Dave Richard joins us on the other side, so stick around. Welcome back to the show. Dave Richard joining me. And Dave, Jamie, your colleague, paid you a nice compliment, saying you were top-tier talent. But what about Brett Favre, his highly anticipated debut with the Jets? Solid performance.
And he's top-tier talent, too, Lauren. And Favre really came out great. Nice touchdown pass to Dustin Keller. His only incompletion of the night, a drop pass. The offensive line is good. The receivers are good. The running backs are good. And you know that Brett Favre is good. He is a solid number one fantasy quarterback. Interceptions might be a problem. And I still have yet to look into the research about how quarterbacks do in the Meadowlands. You know, Eli Manning, Phil Simms, Chad Pennington. You can look at all the quarterbacks that played there. There weren't many that were regular 250-yard throwers.
Well, you know what? He always says his arm hurts. He always says that, but he always plays fine.
If you've been playing quarterback in the NFL for 18 years, you'd be saying your
arm's
going to
hurt.
Too.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, Calvin Johnson played well against the Bengals. He didn't play a lot, but when he was in there, it was solid.
John Kitna loves Calvin Johnson. 3 receptions, 76 yards, and a touchdown, I believe. Oh, no, that's only his first touchdown of the preseason, but Johnson has huge stats. Kitna's already called him a freak of nature. And you know what, fantasy football owners, they love the hype and they're buying the hype of Calvin Johnson. Nice big target. Does have an issue with the back. He could have an injury because he goes for that jump ball, reaches over the 5'10" cornerback and comes down on his back. He's going to get hurt at some point this year. But until he does, I think he's a great option as a number 2 fantasy wide receiver. And we're toying with the idea of having him surpass Roy Williams on our projections. That would mean that Calvin Johnson would be the best option at wide receiver from Detroit ahead of Roy Williams.
Wow, if he can stay healthy, unlimited potential there.
Absolutely, unlimited.
All right, Dave, well, you were in Philly for the Panthers-Eagles. What did you see? Delhomme coming off surgery, how did he look?
Yeah, Delhomme looked great coming off the surgery. It was a downpour in Philadelphia. The game was postponed for an hour because of weather, but Delhomme looked good, and he looked good without Steve Smith, without DJ Hackett. Both of them were back in North Carolina while the Panthers played at Philadelphia. But the players that I came away impressed with on the Panthers was D'Angelo Williams. Came in there in every single aspect with the first team offense, ran the ball at the goal line, was in there on third downs, was able to do everything that they asked of him, and he was successful. He's been doing it all preseason long. We've moved him up and moved Jonathan Stewart down because of this. Stewart was in there 4 carries for 3 yards. Not good production against a second string defense in Philadelphia. I talked with Jonathan Stewart after the game. He says his toe is going to be a lingering injury all season long, and he said that it took him a year in college to get used to the college game. He figures it'll take him that long to get used to the NFL game, too. So I don't want anybody who needs a year to get acclimated. I want him next year. I don't want him this year. I think D'Angelo Williams is starting to become a huge sleeper.
D'Angelo has the leadership. He has the speed. He really wants to hang on to that starting position.
He does, and he's got the maturity, too. We talked about this in the locker room after the game, and he says, I'm ready. I want to be the guy for Carolina. I know I'm going to have to share carries with Stewart, but I think I can be the big back there. And he was at Memphis, too. He had several solid years at Memphis doing it all for the Tigers.
All right, what about DeSean Jackson for the Eagles? Is he going to perhaps, Dave, play a bigger role in the offense than originally thought?
Yeah, he's going to do exactly that. Listen to this, Lauren. He was targeted 14 times. That means the ball was thrown at him 14 times in a preseason game. He worked with the first team. He worked with the second team. He almost had a deep touchdown where he had his man beat by a full yard and a half, 2 yards. Awesome speed. Is a little dinged up right now at the moment. He was nursing his finger in the locker room after the game. He's going to be a little injury prone because he's a little guy, but he's going to get a lot of catches in that West Coast offense in Philadelphia. We've moved him up. He's a top 40 receiver now in fantasy football. Look for him to go with a mid-round pick. Second best receiver in Philadelphia behind Kevin Curtis, way ahead of Reggie Brown.
At just 5'10". He's 5'10".
Yeah,
he's
small. Well, speed kills in the NFL.
All right, that's right. Thanks so much, Dave. Well, we appreciate you tuning in. See you next week. Until then.